Hello everybody, on this video I want to show you some useful information if you are proceeding at first to some United States ports, what the tests and drills should be carried out before entering to the navigational waters of United States and where you can find this information. All information regarding United States regulations you can find in publications code of federal regulations, CFR publications. Normally it's three publications. If you have a hard copy, you will have these three publications, Title 33, Title 46 and Title 49. So the main for you is Title 33, Navigation and Navigable Waters. And in this publication you will find the information regarding tests and drills which will be carried out before entering to the navigational waters of United States. So we have in soft copy these publications. If you are using program One Ocean, you will find this information in Reg for Ships, US Waters regulations. So now we can open this Title 33, Navigation and Navigable Waters. And you will need Part 164. So, Subchapter P, Ports and Waterways Safety. Part 164, Navigation Safety Regulations. Open this. And we will need to find paragraph 164.25. Scrolling down. So 164.25 tests before entering or getting underway. Except as provided in paragraph B and C of this section, no person may cause a vessel to enter or get underway on the navigable waters of the United States unless no more than 12 hours before entering or getting underway the following equipment has been tested, and it listed below. So no more than 12 hours before entering on the navigable waters of United States, what should be tested? Primary and secondary steering gear, the test procedure in class, a visual inspection of the steering gear and its connecting linkage, and where applicable, the operating of the following: each remote steering gear control system, each steering position located on the navigation bridge, the main steering gear from the alternative power supply if installed, each rudder angle indicator in relation to the actual position of the rudder, each remote steering gear control system power failure alarm, each remote steering gear power unit failure alarm, the full movement of the rudder to the required capabilities of the steering gear. Second, all internal vessel control communications and vessel control alarms. Third, standby or emergency generator for as long as necessary to show proper functioning, including steady state temperature and pressure readiness. Pressure readings. Storage batteries for emergency lighting and power system in vessel control and propulsion machinery spaces. Main propulsion machinery ahead and astern. So, if you are proceeding to some ports of United States, this test should be carried out before entering on the navigable waters of United States. If your vessel navigating on the Great Lakes, you will need this information also. But if you are not navigating on the Great Lakes, you will need this information. From 1 to 5. So, and regarding drills. No vessel may enter or be operated on the navigable waters of the United States unless the emergency steering drill described below has been conducted within 48 hours pre-war entry and logged in the vessel logbook. Unless the drill is conducted and logged on a regular basis at least once every 3 months, these drills must include at a minimum the following: operation of the main steering gear from within the steering gear compartment. It's a local operation from the inside the steering gear, and operating of the means of communication between the navigating bridge and the steering compartment. You will need to check also this emergency communication between steering gear room and bridge. Operation of the alternative power supply for the steering gear, if the vessel so equipped. So, if you are proceeding at first to some ports of United States, you will need to make this test before entering on the navigable waters of United States, as per this paragraph. All these tests and emergency steering drill. So all these tests no more than 12 hours before entering, and emergency steering drill within 48 hours before entry. And you will need to make the entry in your official deck log book. It's not needed to write all this information in deck log book. You just will need to write date, time, all tests carried out as per CFR 33, part 164.25. So, this is the main information for you, if you are proceeding at first to the United States. And also, you should remember regarding special emission control area in the United States, SECA area, and Wright Valley area. This is seasonal, Wright Valley area. After I will show you on the EGDIS, on the chart, where you can find this information regarding SECA area and the Wright Valley area. If you are using this program One Ocean, you can find this information in EnviroManager. In EnviroManager, you can see this is SECA area. Inside this area, vessel should proceed on a low sulfur MGO fuel oil. Low sulfur MGO inside this area. And this is Wright Valley area. If you are coming to New York, it's radius 20 nautical miles from the entry of this bay. This 20 nautical miles radius, so inside this area you should proceed not more than 10 knots. You can proceed at a speed 10 knots or less. Also, if you are coming to Baltimore, Savannah, some ports in Canada. So this is seasonally, it's not all year. I will show you on the chart also where you can find this information. So that's what I show you, the main information, the main rules when you are proceeding at first to the United States ports. And now we are coming to EGDIS. I will show you on the chart where you can find this SECA area is marked and Wright Valley area. You see it's here Savannah, before Savannah also, this is Rite Valley area, Baltimore, New York. So now we are proceeding to Agdis. So where you can find on the charts, on the Agdis, the boundary for the Seca area and for the seasonal Rite Valley area. So on this chart, this is the east coast of United States, and you can see the line like this. It's around all coast. This is the boundary of the Seca area. You can find this line on all charts, on all axes. So after this line, inside this area, vessels should proceed on a low sulfur fuel oil with sulfur content not more than 0.10%. So after this line, you should proceed on a low sulfur fuel oil with sulfur content, I repeat, not more than 0.10%. So, and after, I will show you in MARPOL where you can find this information, the coordinates for this line, for these points. So, and regarding Rite Valley seasonal area, it's normally, if you are proceeding to New York before entrance to the bay, if you are proceeding to Baltimore before entrance to the Chesapeake Bay, and if you are proceeding to Savannah, it's here also, this Rite Valley area, and in some ports, in some areas of Canada. So, for example, we are coming to New York. I will show you how you can find this information, this boundary for this area. So you can see the line like this. This is the radius, 20 nautical miles from the entrance to the bay. 20 nautical miles radius. How to check the information? On the Agdis GRC, by right click, you can press S57 CMAP RC information. On other Agdis, it's calling chart info or peak report. You can press by left click on this line. You can see restricted area. Press on this and you can see the info. North Atlantic Rite Valley seasonal management area. All vessels greater than or equal to 65 feet or 19.8 meters in length must slow to speeds of 10 knots or less. So inside this area you should proceed with a speed not more than 10 knots or less. So this is seasonal area, not all the year. Also is here you can find the periodic date. It started from 1st of November each year and ended 13th of April each year. So during this period you can proceed only with speed 10 knots or less inside this area. At the summertime you can proceed on any speed, no restriction. After the 13th of November, 13th of April up to 1st of November, no restriction, speed restriction. So and now I will show you in publication MARPOL where you can find the information regarding Seca area. The information regarding Seca area you can find in publication MARPOL Consolidated Edition 2017. This is mandatory publication for all vessels. If you have this publication in hard copy, you will see the same picture. MARPOL Consolidated Edition 2017. We have this publication in soft copy, in Digitrace, and also in program One Ocean. In content, you will need to open Annex 6, Prevention Pollution of Air from Ships. Annex 6. You can see Annex 6, Prevention of Air Pollution from Ships. You will have the same content in your hard copy. And also, we have this publication in program One Ocean. We can open MARPOL Annex 6 regulations for the prevention of air pollution from ships. Open this Annex 6 and in Chapter 3, Regulation 14. Sulfur oxides and particulate matter. Open this regulation and you will see the next information. Requirements within emission control areas. It's the Baltic Sea area, North Sea area, North American emission control area, the United States, Caribbean Sea emission control area, and you will see the next. While a ship is operating within an emission control area, the sulfur content of fuel oil used on board that ship shall not exceed 0.10%. So, and before crossing the boundary of SECA area, you will make changeover from one year fuel oil to low sulfur fuel oil, and you will need to make the record in your logbook. You can see, shall be recorded in such logbook. So you will need to make the entry in your official deck logbook. And now I will show you where you can find the coordinates. For example, if you don't have on the charts of the exits, you cannot see this line, how to apply it manually, where to find these coordinates. These coordinates, if you have this MARPOL Consolidated Edition 2017, in Annex 6, you also will find all this information with coordinates. And if you have a soft copy, in Annex 6, we will open Appendix 7. Appendix 7, it's a North American Emission Control Area, Regulation 13.6 and Regulation 14.3. North American Emission Control Area. Open this Appendix 7. And you can see all the coordinates. The coordinates for the Pacific Coast of United States and Canada, Atlantic Coast of the United States, Canada and France, also Hawaii Islands, Atlantic and Caribbean Coast. So all coordinates is here. I repeat, if you don't have on the chart this line, this information, in any time using the MARPOL, you can apply this line, this boundary for the SECA area manually using these coordinates. So if this information was useful for you, you can subscribe on my channel. Thank you very much and goodbye.